Hallelujah.
That was music on a different frequency.
Ele to ni orin ni ona mi.
Can we put our hands together to say thank you to Jesus forever?
E ja pato fun Jesu.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Igba mi ko ki se n to je pe o le lati mo igba ti Olorun fe yi itayan pada. Nigba ti a ba ri bi ogogo se n lo amo ti Olorun fe so.
Amen. Somebody came in here and he decided what supposed to be 500 per copy to go for free.
Eni kan wa si bi ohun to ye ko ta ni egberun ogorun marun naira le kokan olohun fun yan lo fe. Oh,
so
sowing
is the only thing that guarantees a harvest. When you are pressing God, you are sowing seed of appreciation.
Nigba ti o ba yin Olorun, o se ni o furugbin pe o mo riri Olorun ni.
Determine the best bus stop to meet you.
O ni eni na ti o so ibi ti o ti bo pade.
May the Lord bless that man in the name of Jesus.
O gba ja pe ki Olorun bo ku fun okunrin ni oruko Jesu.
It was like the same thing that happened last week.
Se lo dabi ohun ti o sele ni ose to koja.
When we went for a crusade at Ife.
Nigba ti a lo fun ijire ni Ife.
And the crusade was organized by His Royal Majesty.
E ti o je pe oba wa ti won wa lori ijoko yi.
And then there was a house where we were, and then we were just there. And then one man, as soon as he just saw, he said, "Ah, is this my pastor?" I was wondering. I said, "Oh, good to see you." I said, "Can you please remind me of where we met or what is it?" He said, "Sir, I've been to a success camp. When things were tough and we prayed and prayed. And the answer is here." You know what? I never imagined what we are going to meet. Until when we just walked into a new, brand new Odua radio station. Brand new radio station. And he said, "You are going to now be offered a free operation." And then, before I knew what was going on, I said, "You are going to preach to everybody. They are going to hear you live now." And he also made me to make commitment and said, "As soon as we send for you, you are also going to come because it's going to be for free for you. All the messages you have ever preached, as soon as you send it to us, we will air it." Indeed, by the grace of God, is also he has promised that he's going to be in this convention. Live and direct. May the Lord bless all of our benefactors. Are we saying amen to that effect? There is nothing sweeter than to know the voice of God. The voice of the Lord is the only thing that gives you assurance. And for this convention, not as we wish, but as he has approved. And that is why this day, we are going to have a very unique man of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This our God is an unlimited God. Amazing God by all dimensions. The story this night will be from Gloryland Ministry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I had rather build my cottage on top of the rock than to build my edifice on top of the sand. So today is another day. We are going to listen to God's mind. is coming directly from where he has hidden all the way long for days. Directly to this place now. So we're going to rise up on our feet.
He's
a man that a good number of us may not have known. But he's known by God, approved by God. Believed by God, anointed by God. This man shared our spirit. And so we put our hands together. While I invite to this place Pastor Tunde Ajiboye. Shall we put our hands together to say thank you to Jesus forever?
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
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 That amen is lame.
Oh, yaro die.
It's so lame.
Anything you ever do, you.
Anyone that is so joyful.
To sin tell me ninu emi.
And you're very happy.
To je ni keji.
And it's the second person.
Ori mi le ni akoko.
Because I'm going to be the first.
To je ni keji mi.
The person that will be the second person.
Tinu re si to ji na jo doin.
That is very happy to be in this anniversary.
Je ko ki hallelujah kan to ni agbara.
Anyone shall shout a wonderful hallelujah. That is a little better.
Nigeria is sick.
Nigeria is sick. Maybe it's a disease. But you are not sick.
Emi o sai so.
I'm not sick. Under whatever circumstance. You, it justified you. And you are here today. I want you to shout hallelujah as you are alive.
Hallelujah, boti wo.
The hallelujah, any star you
one,
want.
1, 2, 3, go. Ha. Let somebody shout
hallelujah.
Oh God. Amen.
Amen.
Adara udari.
He is never weary. Holy Spirit will say thank
you.
Your strength never fails. Over my life. Holy Spirit, I say thank you. Holy Spirit, I say thank you. Holy Spirit, I appreciate you. In my life.
Thank you. Yeah.
glory to the name of the Lord. Brethren, I want you to lift up your voice in prayer. The Ancient of Days. What is it that the world has not given to me but the request of me? Father, do not let them take it away from me. Prayer in the name of Jesus. The things that they did not give to me but the request of me. Father, do not let them take it away. Father, do not let them take it away. That which they did not give to me. That which I collect from me. But the request of me. Father, do not let them take it away. Pray very well. Pray very well. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Call the name of Jesus once. The Holy Spirit of God wants. And say, Lord, who is assigned against my miracle? The enemies assigned against me. In order to stop my miracles. God of covenant. Tonight. Let them die in my life. So that my miracle can get to me. Pray in the name of Jesus. Pray very well. Pray. Every element that is against my miracle. Now, Lord, let them die tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Pray this top prayer. The enemy and the accuser of my joy. Lord, let's grace them in this convention. The enemy and the accuser of my joy. Lord, put them to shame in this convention. Lord, put them to shame. So in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, put them to shame. In this convention. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Before you say that, I want you to pray two more prayer points. So that everything that will go on in this convention, you might understand. Because without you praying, it will be hard. Tell the Almighty God. The Lord give him for the Holy Spirit within me. Anyone that lacks the Spirit of God, this program will just come and go. Even all they are saying, I don't understand. But Holy Spirit will become your teacher to everyone in the world. And that is why. Okay, that there is no fool in heaven. So, because of this, call out on the name of Jesus. That Ancient of Days. Give room for the Holy Spirit of God. Give room for your spirit. Let the Holy Spirit of God in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, give room for your spirit within me. Lord, Holy Spirit of the living God. Fill my life. Holy Spirit. Fill my life.
Holy Spirit.
Without the Holy Spirit of God in man, the man is dead. The man is dead. The man is dead. Holy Spirit, fill my life. 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 Holy Spirit, 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 fill my life.
Yes, Oluwa.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want you to lift up your two hands. The Father, let the Holy Spirit journey with me in this convention. Let the Holy Spirit journey with me in this convention. Let the Holy Spirit of God journey with me in this convention. The Holy Spirit journey with me in this convention. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, journey with me in this convention. Father, let your spirit journey with me. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let's go on our knees. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Your thank you, the one that owns authority.
Eshe o arugbo ojo ohun ibare akoda aye ohun e mo se o alase orun
eshe eshe atobiju
baba mi
eshe o arugbo ojo ohun
baba mi
ibare
akoda aye o olorun e mo se o alase orun
Brother, begin to appreciate the Lord. Appreciate He that gave you the grace. The one that has helped you. Appreciate your mercy. That has given you the opportunity to be here today. Lift him up. Say, Lord, I thank you. He did not receive anybody. And he did not receive anybody. He did not collect
anybody.
He kept you alive. Appreciate him. The enemy had wanted to kill you. But God has not allowed them to kill you. The enemy wants to use their sacrifice. But God has not allowed them to
kill you.
Appreciate him. Say, Lord, I thank you. Appreciate him that gave you
wisdom.
Appreciate him that gave it to you.
Dupe lowo re.
Appreciate him.
Fun eni to fun eni ogbon.
He that gave you the wisdom.
Dupe lowo eni to fun eni oye.
Appreciate him that gave you understanding.
Dupe lowo eni to fun eni imo.
Appreciate him that gave you knowledge.
So fun ko se.
Say, Lord, I thank you.
Eni to le ka e ma wa laye.
Appreciate the living God.
So fun ko se.
Say, Lord, I thank you.
Ile baba mi o mo se o.
My Father, I thank you.
Ki se mi mo se o.
It's not by my well doing.
Ki de se agbara mi.
Neither by my power.
Ki de se pa mi.
Not by my strength.
Ni mo fi le wa laye
lo. That I'm alive today.
O se o.
Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, Oluwa.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Arugbo Ibani.
The Ancient of Days.
Akobi ninu awon oko.
The first among the dead.
Omo ti n gbe ninu baba.
The son that lives in the father.
Baba ti n gbe ninu omo re soro.
The father that speaks through his son.
Olorun ti n gbe ninu ide asola.
The God that lives in the life of virgin.
Edu Maria gbe nu Adele Boshogo.
He also that live in the life of the married ones.
Obi Bimbiri.
Is the all-round God.
Ajo Ikuda.
He that changed out the day of death.
Aremu Odi Orun.
He is the only prince in heaven.
Apala to se lo aye ro.
The mighty hand that opened the earth.
Eru Jejele ti Okun.
He that is fearful.
Ekun Oko Pharaoh.
The God of Pharaoh.
Kiniwun Eya ti Judah.
The lion of the tribe of Judah.
Gbogbo idile Jesse.
The God of Jesse.
that God that received the prostration of other kings, the greatest advocate, the greatest judge that judged the whole
world.
Without you, there is no me.
All
glory to your name, the Son of Mary, our Redeemer. He that gave himself as a propitiation because of my life.
It
was killed so that I would not be killed.
It
was chastised so that I would not be chastised.
It
was oppressed so that I would not be oppressed.
It
was afflicted so that I would not be afflicted.
It
was nailed to the cross that I would not be nailed to the cross.
All
glory to your name. Holy Spirit, my friend, my helper, my teacher, he that speaks through me, he that helps me to do it, the strength in my strength, the power in my power, the wisdom in my wisdom, the knowledge in my knowledge, the understanding in my understanding, I say thank you. I attach myself to you. Holy Spirit, uphold me. Your children are here to hear your word. Holy Spirit, speak to them. Let them understand your word. We are in a time of convention.
In
the God of blessing.
Baba,
my father, bless us. Meet with us. And let us go back home justified. All glory to the name of the Lord. Your beloved, Father, bless them. Uphold them. At the end of it all, let all glory be yours. In Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah. Let's be seated. It is well with us. It is well with us. It is well with me. I appreciate God greatly.
He
that gave me this wonderful privilege to be among those that will stand before the elect. To stand before the elect. People of honor. All glory to the name of the Lord. I appreciate God and the life of my father. And my mommy. You know their name. The Lord will be with you, sir. The Lord will uphold you,
man.
I appreciate God for the lives of those that surround them and the ministers. In the name of Jesus, we shall all get to heaven. To all the workers, we shall not work in vain. I appreciate also the church of God, that they are always thirsty for the word of God. Those that always think about heaven, not only this world, God of all round blessing will bless your life in the name of Jesus. I appreciate you all once more, and I'm so joyful for the song that choristers sang. I speak as a servant of the Lord. In the book of Acts of Apostle 27, the Act of Apostle 27, verse 7 to 8. Paul said, when I was going, I got to Kindo. He said, the storm in Kindo did not allow me. And in verse 8, he said, when I almost, with all strength, I passed through and I got to a place. A place called Fair Heaven. As the Lord liveth and heaveth, you shall get to your fair heaven. You shall get to your fair heaven. You shall not die on the way as a smoke. That song was so beautiful. But I have something. I have a plea. Can you give me the song, a copy of it?
Yes or no?
It is well with you.
Okay. emi o ki se alejo.
I'm not a stranger.
Ninu ijo majemo tutun.
In the New Testament church.
Ise to lodumori ran mi.
The work that God has sent me.
Oni mo fe je.
Is what I'm here to deliver.
Oni kaluku l'Olorun fun ni ebun to yato.
Because what we look unto God for is different.
Ibi o we ori keji din ni ogun.
In the book of Proverbs 18.
Ese ikerin din ni ogun.
Proverbs 18. It said the gift of a man will make him to stand before great men. And the gift of a man will make way for him. Anyone that keep his or her own gift. Or someone who is shy with the gift. The person will be stagnant. Because what God gave to A is different from the one for B. Before I leave your presence today, the secret to the battles of your life shall not be hidden. The secret to the battles of your life shall not be hidden. Someone might be in the house of the Lord and have known Jesus for years and has not received the blessings of God. Someone can even be very close to the altar, very close to the altar of God, but is far away from the Holy Spirit. Though they are close to the altar, but they are far from the Holy Spirit. They are far from the Holy Spirit. But as the Lord liveth, that area that I'm here to amend, that the devil has confronted my life, that area where you need to amend, that the devil has come to oppress you, the Lord shall expose it tonight. Let's open our Bible to the book of Deuteronomy 28. The book of Deuteronomy 28. We are going to look at it from verse 1 to 24. But because of our time, I'm going to look at it from verse 1 to 3. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I commanded this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth, and this blessing shall come on thee and overtake thee. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the field. The God of blessing. There is a law. There is a law. Truly is a God of blessing. And he can bless thousands of people. But there is a law to it. In the book of Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah 1 verse 19. I'm moving very fast because of
Isaiah
our time.
1:19.
The book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19. Okay, if he will be willing and obedient, he shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing and obedient, he shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing and obedient, he shall eat the fruit of the land. Both good and bad. That God created this world. And anyone going to heaven must be ready to listen to the truth. Anyone that wants to be blessed must be ready to listen to a righteous word. We are not here to deceive ourselves. Our God is a God of blessing indeed.
He
is a God of vengeance. And I can say he is a God that can always ask you when he has done good for you. Well, we sang a song at the time. It said God doesn't ask you when he has done good. If you get to that point, he will ask of you.
Ben.
Though he's meek and is gentle, for thousands of years he might not be angry, but once his anger is not
good.
Our God is a God that asks of you whenever you do good and you do not return. In the book of Judges 10, you might wonder what's wrong with the pastor. As deeper or closer you move to God, then that will tell the deepness of God. Move away from the group of people that said the pastor said. The Bible says, in the book of Judges 10, from verse
6
to the last verse, God began to ask, and this was very hard. I have saved you from the battles of
Philistine,
the Philistines, the Egyptians. The Amorites. But still, you do not know me as your Lord. You serve other gods. Go and call on those gods today to save you.
He
said, Lord, save us.
He
said, I will no longer save you. The word of I will no longer
bless
you will not come against your life in the name of Jesus.
It
will not come to your life in the name of Jesus. Anyone that wants to be blessed in life, you need to observe some things. If you miss out on these things, the person will come to this world and go back the same way. He or she will not be blessed. And God is so good to us.
He
is so good to us. And truly, He can bless us. But the Bible says, in the book of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 8, from verse 17. To
18.
He said, I love them that love me. And those that seek me early, such shall find me. Sir, riches, honor,
Isaac,
great wealth are with
me.
And I give to whoever that pleases
me.
To whoever that pleases me. Anyone that does not know how to use wealth, such people will lose the blessings of God. People that do not know how to give, they will also lose out on the blessings of God. Those that rely on their own wisdom, they will lose out on the blessings of God. Brethren, let's have understanding of this. Such people will lose out on the blessings of God. Truly, you might have good certificates. Or even you can speak good English. Or you speak and people look at you. They all congratulate you after you graduated. And you are happy. But after the graduation, you need some things. Your wisdom cannot put you on the run. Your certificate cannot get you to where you're going. It's only to showcase you to the world. If you are asked that if you pass through the school, this is my certificate. Any certificate that does not have a glorious destiny. A glorious destiny without the Holy Spirit of God will not speak to the world. I speak to your life. That which will make your life to speak. That which will take you from onlooker to someone that people will look. The
nation
of grace will release it to your life in the name of Jesus. I speak the second time. That
will
take you away from the group of onlookers. And will make you someone that people will gather to look at. It's not because there's no Jesus in your home. Or there's no church beside your house. Or that there's no Jesus where you are. But in the life of someone, heaven has made him a man that people gather to look at. He has moved away from the group of spectators. Today, you shall move away from the group of spectators. And you shall be someone that people will gather to look at.
If
that will hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord, blessed shall thou be. in the home, in the town, and blessed shall thou be in the field. Blessed are the seed of your womb, and the fruit of your land. And God is a God of all round blessings. God of all round blessings. And his blessings has no limit. Let's open our Bible. Let's open our Bible to the book of Matthew. The book of Matthew, chapter 6.
What will I say?
From verse 31 to the last verse. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all those things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of those things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all those things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for tomorrow, for tomorrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof.
Amen.
Amen. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will suffice for itself. Do not think about what to eat. What you eat, God knows. Yours is to seek first the kingdom of God. Anyone that wants to be blessed in life, they seek first the kingdom of God.
Okay,
I will not tarry long on this preaching. Then we'll move on to prayer. But please let me your ears. Anyone that do not seek the kingdom of God, heaven will not release blessings to them. Anyone that has lost God, he has lost eternal blessing. Anyone that lose the salvation has lost heaven. A lot of people, they put their mind on their wealth, their power, and all their possession. But God make me to understand very well. Very well. That if it's only this thing that you are able to hold tonight, as this year is coming to an end, you shall prosper. In the remaining days of this year, you shall prosper. Anyone that wants to be blessed, you need to ask something. And what is that thing that you need? In the book of Luke, chapter
18,
from verse 29 and 30. And he said unto them, verily I say unto you, there is no man that hath left house, or parent, or brethren, or wife, or children, for the kingdom of God's sake, who shall not receive manifold more in this present time, and in the world to come, life everlasting. How many of us want blessing today?
Now what is okay?
Let's lift up our hands. We all want to be blessed. Verily, verily, I say unto you, that there is no one that will leave his own, his land, children, wife, husband, family, that will forsake them. He will leave them. That will not get to the kingdom of God. No one. Anyone that loves blessing and does not know how to give to God, that blessing will not last long. Someone that holds something too precious and you don't know how to give that thing out to God, that blessing will not soon depart from him or her. That That is so easy that Jesus has said. He said, but anyone that will forsake the children, the wife, that even though he forsook them, he will have in the and in the life eternal,
it
will have abundance, manifold blessings. It will have abundance and manifold blessings. That is, he's going to back up his ministry.
He's
talking about people that cannot back up other people's lives. Or someone that is not sure of his coming to the world. Someone will say, oh, if not for this person, I might not have gone to school. If not for this mommy, I will not be where I am. You have three cars. You have 4 hours. You have great companies. You have money. But your life has no impact in the life of another. You are poor. There is no impact that you made in the life of another person. You are wretched. Blessings is not to disobedient children. Blessings is not to people that squander. Blessing is not to people, the wasters. Blessing is not to children that cannot appreciate God. God gives. And he also tests.
In the Genesis 22.
In the book of Genesis 22. God made promise of Isaac to Abraham. He made a promise of Isaac to Abraham. Though the promise tarried. But the promise came. God gave him a son.
Genesis 22.
In the book of Genesis 22. From verse 1 to 16.
24.
Is that Abraham? Give me the son. The greatest danger was what how God came to him. You said you're going to give me a child. Now you gave me the child. My wife gave birth at the age of 17. And now you are asking for the child.
Abraham so fun Sarah.
Abraham, tell Sarah.
Sarah le je oludena ibuku Abraham.
Sarah could have stand as an obstacle to the blessings of Abraham.
Nitori irora to la koja laye re.
Because of the pain she went through. I and your son were going to a place. I and your son were going to a place. God was waiting for him. God was looking. If he would do it, or he will not. We all know the story.
Abraham
did the will of God. And what did the Bible say? What am I trying to say? There is nothing that Abraham's holds extremely. People that hold things in esteem. Such people. They will always lose greater things than what they have. As soon as Abraham got to the place, he was to make the sacrifice. Isaac asked the father. I have sent a knife, I have sent a matches. Where is the ram? He said, my God will provide.
11:24.
Genesis 22. From verse 11 to 24.
Then
he bind Isaac. And he put the knife on his neck. But the voice of the Lord came
from.
He said, Abraham, I have tested you. Do not kill the son. You must not take the life of a man. And God opened the book of remembrance of blessings. And he began to bless him. He said, his blessing shall be as the sea of the
sea.
It shall be as the stars in heaven. How many of us can count the stars in heaven? Just stay where you are. Take a sand in your hand and count it.
As
long as there is no one that can count, everything that I'll do for you,
there will
be no one that will be able to count your blessing. People that are stingy will never enjoy wealth. Anyone that is stingy will not enjoy well.
Proverbs 23 verse 5.
In the book of Proverbs 23:5.
Proverbs
23:5. It said, wealth has wings. That you will see. But I will tell it to fly. Where will it fly to? Fly to my house. Wealth is a visitor. And whoever God pleases, it releases it to them. The blessing of God is a visitor. When we talk about blessing, great blessings, money is not the only blessing. God can give you long life, good health, wisdom. It's a blessing. Unknowledge is a blessing. Anointing is a blessing.
Owo,
money is a blessing.
Ile,
houses,
moto,
cars, children,
aya,
wife,
okorere,
good husband. These are all blessings. My mother in the Lord, she is also a blessing to our father in the Lord. So as to make the New Testament assembly established. And it still continues. And it will continue. Until Jesus comes. It will continue.
Niwa baton form. Aye re yo soro.
As so that it speak, your own life too will speak.
Okay, wo la ro mi le gun.
What mountain can my
like
man climb?
Agbe dide.
Except I'm being raised up.
Oja wo la foju leta.
What trade can a blind man do?
To wo yo fi pe o.
That it will make good profit.
Anu re lo soro.
Lord, it is your mercy.
Lori aye mi o.
That speaks in my life.
Anu to soro ninu aye mama.
It is the mercy of God that speaks in the life of my mother.
Yo si ma soro lo titi lai lai.
And to continually speak. Anyone that wants to be blessed in life, anything at all, they will not hold it in esteem. I want to tell us the truth. It could be as a lie. Only those that are filled with the Spirit of God will understand. There is no word of blessing that will come out without any attachment to it. There is no blessing that will come to your life except that there is something attached to it. Blessing differs from blessing. A man? Okay, if five people. One out of five.
Only check it 25 billion naira.
As a check of 25 billion naira.
Our men it took.
The remaining four.
One song of power.
They came empty.
Aha.
Both of them, all the five people, they knelt.
It only check it lower for daddy.
But the one with the check gave it to our father.
Tani adura re ma posi.
Who do you think the prayer will be much more?
Eh? Me go. Ah.
Someone that brings. That is the person that will receive the blessing from the bottom of his heart.
Genesis 27.
The book of Genesis 27.
Starting from 1.
From verse 1.
What? Isaac
said. Esau, come. Let me bless you. But go to the bush. And bring me a venison. Cook it and make it a
single.
Let me eat and
so
that I can bless you before I die. Blessing without bringing anything is a lie. Anyone that wants to be blessed, look out for the second thing that I'm talking about. Learn how to use a key to open the door of a prophet. the key
lati fi siku wole
to open the heart of a prophet
be won so fun ti sawu
if Esau
to ba le ri eran yen gbe di odo baba e lojo yen
had come with the meat to the father
ti Jacob o yara gbe debe
and Jacob did not go ahead of him
orun a si fun gbogbo
heaven would have opened unto him greatly
gbogbo
greatly
Solomon would have the baba e
Solomon looked at the father David
ninu wi awon ba kini ori keta
in the book of first kings 3
oba kini ori keta
first kings 3
ni ese kini
in verse 1
wa si ese yi kerinla
so verse 14
ṣugbọn ese keta so oro kan
but verse 3 says something
oni pe
it says
Solomon rubo egberun ore
that Solomon made thousands of sacrifices
Olorun wa wo
and God looked on
oni Solomon
says Solomon
David baba re ko se ru eleyi ri
David your father never did this
nitori pe ko se ru eleyi ri
and because he never did it
bere on to ba fe lowo mi
ask whatever you want from me
Solomon bere to fe
and Solomon asked what he wanted
omo oyi ati mo
he asked for wisdom and understanding
arugo igba ni wi pe
and the ancient of this said
saju re
before you
ati keyin re
and after you
ko se ni to tu o
there is no one that will be great as you have
nipo fun mi ni ti baba re o fun mi ri
and because you gave me that which your father never gave to me
emi na fun eni ti fun eniyan ri
I will give you that which I never gave to any man
eni keni to ba fun olorun ni eni keni o fun ri
someone that gives to God that which no one has ever gave to him
olorun yo silebu iku funfun
God will open door of blessing to them
kuro ni ku eniyan ti o ma gba
move away from the group of people that receive
you come agbasa
people that receive at all times
you come agbasa
people that receive at all times
you come agbasa
people that receive at all times
wa ni ipo eda tin fi fun eniyan
be among the group that gives
ben look ori refa
the book of Luke chapter 6
ese keji din ogoji
from verse 42
38 oni o fi fun mi emi o fi fun
e say give and it shall be given to you
osun to o ba fi won
the measure that you measure
lemi o fi won fun o
it shall be measured back to you
pen akipo
press down
akunwo sile
shaking together running over
lemi o fi da pada fun o
shall men give to your bosom
opo lo ti lo ye ko ti di eni ibukun
a lot of people ought to have been blessed
mori oba oro laarin wa
I say the king of wealth among us.
Oba oro.
The king of wealth.
Be o se mi laanu pe ko sade lori won.
But it's a pity.
O si ade lori won.
That there is no crown on them.
Mo ri oba oro.
I can say the king of wealth.
Ti ma so nipa oba oro.
When we talk about the king of wealth.
Eniyan kan ti o wi pe.
A man that will say.
E ma beere nkan kan lowo eniyan
sir. Please don't ask anything of any man.
E je ki mo nkan ta nilo nu
ajo mi. Let me know the thing that we need for this convention.
Ma so fun.
I will pay.
On to ko ba eni na ni
this is what has hindered this man
o je oloto ninu idamewa re
it's because the man is not faithful in the tithe
pupo ninu oluso agutan
a lot of the servant of God
pupo ninu oluso agutan
a lot of the ministers of God
won je oludena
they are hindrance
fun omo ijo won
so they are church members
omo ijo ba ma so lenu je ko so lenu
if they want to speak let them speak
je ko ye pe Oluwa wi pe fi eyi dan mi wo.
Let them know that the Bible said that test me with this.
Oye mi ko ni si fere si orun.
If I will not open the windows of heaven.
Olorun ibukun.
The God of blessing.
O ni window.
He has a window.
Ah, fere se wa nbe.
He has a window.
Ti ko ba si fere se yen.
If there was no window.
Ko si nkan kan ti o sele.
There is nothing that will happen.
Oluso agutan ti ki gba ida mewa lowo omo re.
The minister of God that does not take tithe from the members.
O je ota oludena ibukun
is also an enemy and an hindrance to their blessing
nitori pe omo yen o ni tayo pupo
because such people will not excel
ajenu a wa ni owo re
the destroyer will be there
tori ajenu yi
the destroyer
amo fa isan
will bring in sickness
ijakule
failure
bi ki moto e mo baje
like maybe the car got spoiled
bi ori ma fo
maybe headache
mani ko lo se test kan
o se go and get this test
mani 50,000
this test is 50,000 100,000
o ye wa lo to
do he has the money
a ma lo wa ko bo moto e lojiji
and we go and sell the cars
and amen
he said oh
you have spoiled my car
e mo lo si so
nitori pe ti olo ti ko ba fun olorun esu o gba tipa tipa
Because Eve refused to give to God, the devil will take from him forcefully. Without knowing the things we need to know, we might not be blessed. If the pastor did not collect tithe from you, please pay your tithe. Pay your tithe. The blessings of God are attached with laws. Before Abraham was blessed, he paid his tithe. Anyone that do not pay tithe and offering, their blessings will not be running over. Even if you use the anointing and the day of your ordination, it will not work.
He
said, "Cost shall it be cost."
So anything is saying that we are begging.
That is, those that do not pay their tithe are under cost.
What?
In the book of Isaiah 3,
Isaiah Kewa,
in verse 10,
Ati Kokola, Isaiah Kewa, Isaiah 3:10-11.
The book of Isaiah 3:10-11.
Isaiah Kewa, we pay.
Verse 10 says,
"So for Olododo,
tell the righteous."
But you die for
that it shall be well with him.
What will you buburu?
And say to the wicked, and tell him
that
woe unto him. And it's going to be bad for him. God has both. I believe I'm before those that are blessed. And I speak to your life. It shall be well with you. Anyone that do not pay tithe. Is a thief. Is a thief. And anything that a thief owns, it will lose it one day. If I bless someone, heaven will open. Because of the covenant. But if he or she doesn't pay tithe, in few minutes, heaven will be closed. Because the angel that God has assigned doesn't joke with the word of God. Come to the church. Come to pray. Get a contract. 100 million naira. 100 million naira. And you made profit.
10 million naira.
You made profit of 10 million.
1 million naira.
Just a millionaire.
1 million naira.
1 million naira.
Million kan.
Just 1 million. Is of God.
Oh, what joke lori million yen.
And you now sit on that 1 million.
Wani daddy 100,000.
They say daddy take 100,000.
Wa ran kan 50,000.
Then you buy something of 50,000.
Wa ran 10,000.
Another thing of 10,000.
Wa gba Olorun na idameewa re.
And you help God to spend the tithe.
Ewu be lori re.
There is danger for you.
Oh, le ba Olorun na idameewa laye.
You cannot help God to spend the tithe.
Laye.
At all.
To bank say that me ware boti to ati boti ye.
If you pay your tithe as due,
wa gbadun ifokanbalẹ.
You will enjoy rest.
Wa gbadun ominira.
You will enjoy freedom.
Oni si tan pe ni inira.
There will be nothing called oppression.
Ton ba yo gbogbo eniyan lenu oni yo lenu.
If everybody else is troubled, you will not be troubled.
Iwo gan le si regun.
Then you yourself, you can even talk to others.
Isaiah 38.
The book of Isaiah 38.
Isaiah 38. Isaiah 38.
Ezekiah was sick.
Olorun de won wo ni Isaiah sick.
And God sent a prophet Isaiah to him. And he faced the wall after he received it.
Oluwa.
He said, Lord, know how faithful I am before you. Look at how I've walked before you. Look at me before you. Look at how perfect I am. He said, you have catched me. You caught me. Because of this, go back and tell him that I had 15 years to his life. Tell the person beside you that God can never owe you. If you want to be blessed in life, make sure you pay your tithe. Tell the person beside you. Tell the person beside you. When you get to your church, tell your minister that daddy, please always ask of our tithe so that
we
will not be under the curse of the law. The third point I'm going to give to us, People that are not merciful, they will not obtain mercy.
We Jacob ori keji esei ketala.
The book of James 2:13.
Jacob ori keji esei ketala.
James 2:13.
Oni wo.
Is that Luke?
Emi o se anu.
I will have mercy.
For anything shanu yi.
To those that have mercy.
Oni lori temi.
Is that on my throne?
Anu shogo.
Mercy triumph.
Eniti ki ba shanu laye ko shanu fun.
For people that are not merciful will not obtain mercy.
Ko si anu fun.
They will not obtain mercy.
Ikeri.
Fourth.
People
that hide their eyes away from the cry of the poor. Don't forget that I said it before. As wealthy as you are, you have no positive impact on the life of another.
Ah,
you are wretched. You don't have any good seed that you have sown. You are only going to see you. You are rich. You have cars. You have houses.
I will die nitori ara re.
You are not created for yourself alone.
I will die nitori iyawo re.
You are not created for your wife alone.
I will die nitori omo re nikan.
You are not created for your children alone.
I will die nitori gbogbo awon to yi e ka pata.
Created for the sake of those that surround you.
Agbe e kale nitori gbogbo awon to yi e ka pata.
You are positioned for the sake of those that surround you. The book of Acts of Apostle 9.
To ba wo lati ese ikerin dini ogoji.
From verse 36.
Very. Esi beli sibe.
Let's open our Bible to it.
Ye kaka.
Let's read it.
Kaka ise meji si meta be. Acts 9.
The book of Acts chapter 9 verse 36. Now there was a Joppa, a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deed, which she did. And it came to pass in those days that she was sick and died. Whom when they had washed, they laid her in the upper chamber. And for as much as Lydda was nigh to Joppa, and the disciples had heard that Peter was there, they sent unto him two men, desiring him that he would not delay to come to them. Then Peter arose and went to them. When he was come, they brought him into the upper chamber, and all the widows stood by him weeping, and showing them the coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all forth and kneeled down and prayed, turning him to the body. Your good works will speak for you. Even if you kneel before an anointed man of God, God will listen to the cry of the man of God because of the covenant he had with him. And you will testify that Daddy God has done it. But because you are callous, you are so cruel, that mercy will not tarry with you. Dorcas was rich. Look at what the widow said concerning her. He said, Peter, my children's school fee.
Dorcas
paid. He said, Dorcas gave
it to me.
The cloth I'm wearing. Dorcas gave it to me. He said, even the food we ate last night. Dorcas gave it to
me.
Once I
paid.
If this woman died, how will I pay for my rent? Son said, Peter, you must not go. Peter heard the good works that this woman had done. And he pushed them all out. He said, God, if it's true, that the life of this woman speaks through others, let her rise from death.
Tabitha,
arise. And she arose. Your good works will speak for you. My good works will speak for me. Learn how to do good. Don't put your eyes away from the cry of the poor. Isaiah 3 from verse 14.
He
said, anyone with the goods of the poor, it will hinder eternal blessings from he or she. You have a garage where you park your car in your house, and you have 7 cars, and God was to give you 3. You have 3 cars in your car, and the tire has flattened. Your first charge could not go in. Your children, They gave it a name.
Oh, le funyan.
And you could not give it out. How would there be space for another? Don't you know that when one is taken out, you are no longer using it. You can't take it to anywhere. And you cannot use it. Your wife cannot use it. Why not take it out? And give it out. And see what God will do. Our God is a man of blessing, but he has principles. He has a lot of principles. Anyone that will not walk according to his principles will keep saying, I didn't prosper in this church. And others are testifying and we'll pray together. Truly we'll pray together. But the steps you're supposed to take, did you take them? You did not. Tell the person beside you that the man of God is speaking to you. I love prayer a lot. Prayer is my ministry. But when I was seeking the face of God, this is what God said to me. By the grace of God, you and I can be here praying till 6 a.m. But if you pray and you are ignorant of the things you need to know, you might go back the same way you came. You might go back the same way you came. The edge here that you have, the cloth you are putting on, it's not a new cloth. This is something Dorcas was no longer wearing. It said the goods of the poor are in your house. That's the way it is in the book of Isaiah 3. What are the goods of the poor that are in your house? If they say, Lord, maybe daddy knelt down, that all those that fell are dead and they have not allowed us to be in darkness, Lord, lighten their life, will you be among those that will be prayed for? Those that support the ministry, Lord bless them. Will you be among them? And there is nothing you give to God that is too little. Nothing. That is too little for God. The cry of the poor must not be bitter in your ears. You must not take your eyes away from the afflicted ones. If you want to be blessed in life, don't separate people. Don't separate anyone. Don't separate anyone. Always look at people as one. And the ancient of days will justify you. That which the devil kept in your life, that has hindered you from being blessed, the fire of God bring it out of your life. So also the minister of God ought to be blessed. So also some of the congregation are not blessed. Some of the workers are not blessed. If you do not believe in giving, to work for God, to have or to show mercy to those that will not tell you thank you, to show mercy to those that do not have what to pay you back with, people that do not have what to pay back with. People that do not have what to pay back with are the people that you should show mercy to. All that God has given to you, let us speak in their life. Just as the life of Dorcas spoke, our good works raise her from the dead. Your good works will raise you up. Your good works will raise you up. The fifth way, I'll stop here. The Bible says, the hand of the diligent shall be made fat.
Anyone
that do and never look back. People that serve God without looking back.
You
clean the house of God, no one saw you. And you were not worried. You continue to do it for God. You are not doing it to man. You also will be blessed.
Benny.
Those that clean the house of God. Those that clean the surroundings. They are also blessed. A woman used to clean the altar in the redeemed camp. Then someone built another house. And God told him, this house, you built it. As you like. But it is not your home. Go to the redemption camp. There is a woman cleaning the altar. Go there this hour. And give her the keys to the house. That woman never thought she could build a house. At all. She never thought she could build a house. I went to minister at the place. Not quite long. Maybe some days ago. After the ministration, the minister that lied will not be a friend of God before I left my house. I said, anything the minister give to me, I'll use it to buy fuel.
It will
make my journey faster. When I was going, the pastor called me.
Pastor
Rotimi called me that if you want to journey to be very fast, I need to do something. And he did it. Then I calculated everything together. That when I get to the place after ministration, it will give me something. Then I heard a voice. I didn't send you to receive a dime. Deliver the message and get back to where you're going. I delivered the message of God and I left. Then a woman stood up. A man. He came.
It's
a man of God. Look at this wristwatch if it will size you. Even if it will not size me. I said yes, it sizes
me.
Then I placed it in my hand. Then the man left. The man of God said, this wristwatch you're wearing. This is the amount of the soul. I said, restore. I said, what if the thief? Then I looked at my hand. I had to keep it well. The resource is as expensive as this. How much would the minister would have given to me? Maybe 50,000. Then look at what God did. That which has hindered you from being blessed. Today,
let it
out of your life in the name of Jesus. Two voices that speak in the life of a man.
No one force in our union. Amen. Oh, alone. Ato won isu ṣugbọn lati oni lo gbogbo ohun ti o fe ko di eni ibukun to n fo si aye re ko ya odi ni oruko Jesu Kristi tọlọrun ba ti fun mi lanfani ma si ti pada wa emi o ki se alejo mbi oni le ni mi dije lori ese re.
Close your eyes. If I pray for you that heaven should open, heaven will open. It's a covenant. He told me long ago. He said you might be different from your siblings, but I want to confirm the wise. It's a covenant. But it will not tire before it's closed off. Close your eyes. Maybe you are not truthful in the work of God, in your house, in your place of work, to those that you ought to help but you did not help them. 1, 2. You always hear a voice that tells you not to do it or not to give. 3. You always hear a voice anytime you make up your mind to give out a millionaire or 500,000 naira, 100,000 naira, 50,000 naira. Another voice will tell you to share, divide into 2 or 3. Don't give him everything. Don't give him everything. Just give him 2,000 naira. You hear such voice. These are the enemies of your blessings. Come out. And I'll pray with you. You hear such voice. Please come out. I'll pray with you. Maybe you want to do something. And a voice always accuses you, saying, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't give. Don't bless him. These are the enemies of your blessings. Come forth. I'm not calling on those that want to give their life to Christ. You are pregnant of good things, but the power has hindered you from delivering. There is no one that will give to God and God will not return. But he knows that if you do, heaven will be open unto you. But he has hindered you. The Deuteronomy 8:18. He said, do not forget the Lord your God that giveth the power to make wealth. Do not forget him. Talk to the Lord. Lord, save me from the flesh. Save me from flesh that has hindered my blessing. Talk to the Lord like that. Talk to the Lord. When you're about to receive the contract, you called on the Lord. And after you received it, you could not do the things that God asked you to do. You made a vow and you could no longer fulfill. That is the enemy of your blessing. Talk to the Lord. Tell God to save you from the enemy of your blessing. The blessing will manifest in this program. And heaven is already open. It's open already. But for you to enjoy that blessing till over, that voice speaks against you. Paul said, the things I do not want to do are the things that I do. He said, the things that I don't want to do are the things that I do. All the things that I said is bad that people should not do. He said, I do it all. Then he said it. He said, it is the spirit in me that did it. But at the end of it, he said, who will save me from flesh? You to tell God. The Lord save me from flesh. Replace flesh with the spirit of God. That I may be blessed alive. Abraham became a blessed man. Solomon was also blessed. David said, I will not give God that which will not pay me. Anyone that wants to be blessed will have to go into a trade with God. If you refuse to trade with God, what will you receive of him? How will you be able to give account or to make God? How would you want to do good to someone? You want to do something to someone. And that spirit is telling you, divide it into 2 or 3. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. A son of days. The fourth man in the furnace of fire. The strong man in the heaven. He that doeth mercy to whoever he please. And lift up anyone alive. He sits in heaven. And do it as a please. No one can question it. All glory to your name. The enemy of the blessings of those people. In the name of Jesus. Hear the word of the Lord. Come out. I command the second time. It is written in the book of Matthew 18:18 that whatever I bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever I lose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Anything that I ask to go will go, and things I ask to stay will stay. The enemies of your blessings, the enemies of your blessings that has hindered your life, that has not allowed your life to speak, in the name of Jesus, come out. Come out. From today, you are free from flesh. And I replace the spirit of God with the flesh. All glory to the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Say, my advocate has justified me. My advocate has justified me. The enemy is supposed to say, I have joy in the Lord. I have become joyful in the New Testament church. My advocate has justified me. If you have received the bill of justification, wave your hands. And if you want to do anything to anyone, that's what you want to do, do it. Don't reduce it. If you reduce it, heaven will reduce your blessing. But if you do not reduce it, your blessing will be great. Go into your joy. It is well with you. Let everybody rise up and lift up your voice. The God of blessing, I have just terminated. The God of blessing, open heaven unto me that I may be blessed in this program. Prayer in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God of blessing, open the heaven unto me that I may be blessed tonight. In the name of Jesus, Lord, in this program, I want to be blessed. Lord, let heaven open. Let heaven open. Let heaven open. Let heaven open. Let heaven be open. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. If you are someone that finds solution to other people's problem, heaven will always search out solution to your problems. It is not a prayer. Even if someone cries to you and you try to make them smile out, I have assurance that at all times God will search a solution to your problems. Tell the Almighty God, it's end of days, save me from the enemies of my blessings. Save me from the enemies of my blessings. In the name of Jesus. Prayer in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, save me from the enemies of blessings. In the name of Jesus. The enemies that have eaten my blessing, Father, save me from them. Lord, save me from the enemies of my blessings.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Hear what the Bible says. You can open your Bible to it.
Deuteronomy 23, verse 5.
The book of Deuteronomy 23, 5. It says something. I love this program so much.
Deuteronomy 23, 5.
Nevertheless, the Lord thy God will not hearken unto Balaam, but the Lord thy God turned the curse into a blessing unto thee, because the Lord thy God loved thee. Because God loved my father, and he has put up this team. He said, because God did not hearken unto Balaam, he turned around the curse to blessing. Tell the Almighty God, the Lord, every curse over my life, under this open heaven, Lord, turn it around to blessing for me. My father, the curse of my life, Lord, turn it around to blessing. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, every curse of my life, Father, because of this open heaven, Father, turn it to blessing. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, turn the curses around me to blessing. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want to do something. If not at the time that I'm in a program, I wouldn't have
lived.
And for us, for the people that want to be blessed, at the time that there is no program, I would have wanted us to lock ourselves up in a prayer room. Without you going after us or chance, you shall be great alive. There is no heart that does not fail or expire. But the blessings of the Lord, it is everlasting. You can do it. Your power suffices. Lord, you can do it. Your power suffices. The God that parted the Red Sea, your power suffices. It is so easy. Agbara reka. Oleseo. Agbara reka. Oba to gbin oko niya. Agbara reka. Oleseo. Agbara reka. Oleseo. Agbara reka. Oba to gbin oko niya. Agbara reka. Jesus once. Holy Spirit of God three times. Now Father, every curse over me, turn it around to blessing. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, every curse over me, Lord, turn it to blessing. In the name of Jesus. Father, turn it to blessing. Every curse hanging over my life, Lord, turn it to blessing. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. God is saying something to me. He says someone is here. And he said, look, you did a job and you made so much profit, but you did not pay your tithe. But he is rich in mercy. He said, look, after this convention, if you refuse to pay the tithe, that which he wants to add to you, he said, the grace will expire. Grace can expire. If you do not believe, grace expires. The day that the secret is let out over someone, the grace has expired. Over Saul, it said, my grace is, I'm taking it away. The grace of God will not expire over your life. Read the book of Deuteronomy 28 well. There are a lot of blessings attached. As I was saying it from the beginning, he said, if you were not acting unto the commander, it's a lie. In the next minute, I have 3 minutes more. Just one prayer. Almighty God, every curse that I've ever been caught from my morning time, Lord, because I'm in the program of blessing, Lord, turn it around to bless. Prayer in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, every curse that I've ever been caught, Lord, my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, every cross hanging over my life, right from when I was young. Father, turn it around to blessing. Because I'm in this program, Lord, turn it around to blessing. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. So stretch out your hand upon Lord. That the troubles of my life will come to an end. I beseech you. Let the water of the flow from your side. Let it bring healing to my soul. Let it bring healing to my soul.
Nawo agbara re o saye mi kidamu aye mi dopin
mo bebe
je ki omi wo san to san lati ara re o se yi iwo san
bless for me
wanawo o
Ami.
O le ni. Eh? O le die. Olodumori. Na wo agbara re saye mi.
Lord, stretch out your hand.
Saye mi dopin mo bebe.
Let the troubles of my life.
O mi wo san to san lati ira re.
The healing water that flow from your side. Let it heal my soul.
Abe dukun la wa.
We are under blessing. Let's close our eyes.
Di oju re.
Let's close our eyes.
Bibeli gbe.
The Bible says that the food meant for children is not meant for dogs. The food of children is not meant for dogs. It's not meant for dogs. If you are in the house of God and you have not given your life to Him, you are a dog. If you are in the church for a long time and there's sin in your life and Jesus does not know you, you are a dog. If you are ready to give your life to Him, I'll pray for you wherever you are. And the blessings of God will abide with you. You will move away from the group of dogs and you become a child. Is there anyone that is ready to give His
life? It's okay. O dara fun yin ma. Ibuku je ti re loni.
Just today, and you are going back home justified. You are going back home justified. If you are ready to give your life to Him, that heaven will open up to you, that your life might speak, that your mockery can become celebration. Raise your hand. Begin to confess your sins. Confess your sins. It is well with you, sir. It is well with you, ma. Begin to confess it to the Lord. And I will have mercy on you. I'm also confessing mine at the time. And He made me His child today. Begin to confess it. Paul obtained mercy for the Lord. Because he was an injurious man. But he became a child of God. All glory to the name of the Lord. Say this after me. Lord Jesus, I give my life to you today. I acknowledge as my Lord and Savior. Have mercy on me. I confess all my sins to you. Write my name in the book of life. Take me away from the group of dogs and make me your child. Let me enjoy your mercy, grace, blessings. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As many that raise their hand, please go on your knees as I pray. Go on your knees as I pray with you. In the name of Jesus. My God, the God that searched out the heart of man, that knows all things and can do all things. They have given their lives to you today. Their book of sin, Father, tear it out. They have given their life to you today. Every work of the devil controlling their lives. The mockery of the devil that is controlling their lives. Father, disgrace the devil controlling their lives. Disgrace the devil controlling their lives. The devil controlling your life. Because of giving your life to God today, my Father will put them to shame. You are going back home justified. Heaven is open unto you for blessing. And it is well with you. All glory to the name of the Lord. Let everybody say amen. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, the God of blessings shall bless you. From today, you are taken away from the group of the poor and you are moving to the group of the rich. In the name of Jesus, you shall not go back home empty. You will not go back home empty. My Father in the heavens,